Now, look, I'm not a huge superstitious person. I don't believe in like omens or ghosts or nothing like that. But this Friday the 13th thing, it's starting to get to me. And if it's not getting to you, you may want to reconsider. Let me explain. See, this afternoon, the news came that we all probably feared, right, considering what we've been seeing with our COVID cases recently. Governor Brown announced a statewide two-week freeze starting next Wednesday, November 18th. Now, this pretty much puts us right back in that whole lockdown mode. You remember that, right? Multnomah County, the lockdown's going to last for at least 4 weeks. So this is a while. Now, this is a rough list of some of the restrictions that we're talking about here. Limited get-togethers, limited faith-based gatherings, no more indoor dining, that's done for a while, or drinking at bars. Gyms, they're closed again. And that really only scratches the surface. I mean, it's a long list. You can find the full list at KGW.com right now, and you should go on there and check it out. Now, of course, this comes after the worst week we've ever had for COVID-19 cases and deaths in Oregon. Just today, we had more than 1,000 new cases and 7 deaths. Now, if you remember the last Friday the 13th in 2020, it occurred back in March, and the parallels, honestly, are kind of tough to ignore. That was the day that both Governors Brown and Inslee shut down schools because of coronavirus, and we kind of think of that week as being the beginning of this current crisis that we're living through. It was like the week everything started to change, and now, I don't know, it kind of feels like that's starting to change again. And I don't need to tell you the obvious thing here, that two-week pause conflicts with Thanksgiving. And historically, that's the biggest travel weekend in the United States. Even with this pandemic raging, not just here, but everywhere in the country, 50 million people are expected to still travel over that holiday weekend. I don't know how many people are going to reconsider after today or what we're currently experiencing. Probably not 50 million. Hopefully some of them do. And if not for themselves, for the people that they may encounter over the holidays. Or maybe for the exhausted healthcare workers, because today we learned that every ICU in the Portland metro area is full or nearly full. And OHSU doctor Esther Chu said today that doctors are tired and they're devastated at the sheer loss.
The really heartbreaking thing about the nature of this disease is that when people come into the hospital, they're isolated right when they need support and company and love the most. It has been really hard for me to see people in the hospital isolated and alone like that. I'm sorry. Many of you cheered and rang bells and put up signs calling us heroes. And we're so grateful for that. Right now, we're asking you to be our heroes. And to listen to our call for help again. We have the opportunity now to save hundreds or thousands of Oregon families from any more of these painful last goodbyes. The way that we will get through the winter safe and healthy and strong is by pulling together and going all in against this virus right now. Now is the time to double down on the only truly effective measures to stop this virus. Wear a mask, keep your physical distance, wash your hands, and for the next 2 weeks, please stay home.
How do you not take that more seriously? I know it's, you don't want to. You wish we weren't where we are, because we are kind of back where we were. The place we didn't want to be. Holiday plans are going to be scrapped. Families are going to be sad. Grandparents will be lonely. And once again, our restaurants will face the prospect of financial ruin.